So you can see it's at 1.66. We want to get it to 1. So there you go. So that'll work. All right. Hey, this is John DeStefano. Would you do it? KAPRO was kind enough to send me a 48-inch level. And we're going to unbox it now and go through some of the features. In the box, they included some swag, a notepad, and a bag carrying case for the level itself. In the carrying case, there's a pouch that contains the instructions and a battery. It says, thank you for your purchase. If there's anything that makes you unhappy with your purchase, please send us an email. And so we have a list of the products the KAPRO provides. And this is the one I have right here, the 985D Digiman. It's a professional magnetic digital level. There's a zipper pouch here. It's covered with plastic. All right, protective plastic over the LCD screen. And we have good lighting, so let's turn my light on here. And it shows that you can see that vial there. Yeah, it's a cool stuff. Super cool. So let's take a look at the directions before we do anything. Okay, so this is the English side. The directions. It says, thank you for purchasing a 985D Digiman professional digital level. You are now the owner of one of our innovative state-of-the-art tools. This tool incorporates new MEMS, microelectrical mechanical systems technology to achieve accurate results and reduce work time. All right, so applications, drywall projects, roof layout and framing jobs, installing stairs and banisters, laying pipe and drainage slopes. Yeah, it's cool. I plan on using this for installing a pad in the backyard behind my house where my grill and lawnmower will be stored. So now on these instructions, it shows how to install the battery. Okay, so I did manage to get the battery installed like that. I think that's the proper way to install it. Getting it back into the level, really not that difficult. I was making it more difficult than what it really is. Okay, so there you go. It is installed. All right, now let's go over the features here. And one of the things that I'm going to use this for is 1% grade for a concrete pad I'm going to put in the backyard. So we'll switch to mode and percent. And now we want to calibrate to, no, I'm not calibrating yet. So 1% grade is what we want to achieve. Okay, so the beeping indicates that we've achieved a level. And I'm looking at the bubbles. I'm looking at the one bubble, and it appears to be dead center. Okay, so there's direction arrows that appear to the left and the right of the numbers. And the direction arrow, these are two direction arrows on either side of the LCD display. They indicate which direction to move the Digiman for a level or plumb measurement. All right, so now we're level. So now I want to switch to 1 degree or percent grade. All right, so this is level. Now if you want to switch to percent grade, we'll lift this up. And we want to go to 1% grade, which is like right about there. So now we can hit the beep so it doesn't go off. Hit it again so it does. And I'm looking at my bubble, and my bubble is indicating that it's pretty much dead on. There's a small amount to the left more than the right. And to change that, I would have to lift this up just a little bit. All right, so hey, this is John. What are you doing? In this video, we're gonna use the KAPRO level. It's a 48 inch level, digital. And we're going to try to get to 1% slope, which I could easily do with the Mason's line and just taking some measurements and getting that line level and then lifting it up a little bit. But we're going to use this out in the wild. You already saw the unboxing, so now we're actually going to put this to use out here. And so we're going to turn it on. Now we are on. All right, now we're going to set up our wood. Because what I plan on doing is, at some point, doing a concrete pad back here so I can have everything looking nice. All right, so I got some 2x6 lumber here, and I plan on having this pad sticking out a little bit from the driveway here. Right about there is 1%. So we can see what our slope needs to be. Yeah, so we just need to get it right on 1%, close enough, and that's going to be perfect for water to shed off of it. And then the step will be right there, and I'll probably put a drain in. So I'll put a drain in there at the end of the concrete to let all the water go away from there to the low spot, which will be someplace in the yard that way, I hope. So you can see it's at 1.66. We want to get it to 1. So there you go. So that'll work. So then we get our board set up with our batter boards. And then that'll be how we get these boards set up. And then we'll dig in. We'll dig in a little bit. We'll put down some fabric. Put down crushed gravel. And then we'll do concrete over top of it. So this will be a pad that's about 10 foot by 10 foot. So we're talking 100 square feet. Probably need like 80 bags, 80 or 90 bags of 60 pound concrete. So yeah, good deal. So that is the KAPRO 48 inch level. Really happy with this. All right, so now let's switch to mode. You can see we're 0.9 degrees. And 1% is about 0.57 degrees. So right about there is 1%. Between 0.5 and 0.6. So yeah, this will be a fun project. Get that going. All right, so we got a problem with our concrete floor in our garage. So our floor is not level. It slopes downward. And the problem with that is when I close the garage door, which I'll show you when I close the garage door. So now the garage door is closing. So you can see they're just the typical New Jersey gap. So in Jersey, we have a lot of settling, so you can see that gap is there. And that's something that I want to... Yeah, so that gap right there. That's the New Jersey gap. You get that because our ground settles a lot. So you can see that's about an inch maybe, inch and a half. Right, so you can see that is... about 1.5 degrees. Right, ideally this would be level. And then out here, where the door closes, we're similar, very close, you know, 1.8. So you can see right there, that's 1 degree. So that's on the left side of the slope here, the apron to the garage floor. You can see that's 1 degree, but over here on this side, it was 1.8 degrees. And it's also evident there with that cracking, the acetylene there. So, hey, you know, that's what we're dealing with. Yeah, but I just wanted to show another application of this level. What level is, and it also gives you arrows that tells you what you need to do direction-wise to get it level. So there you go, that's level right there. So you can see that's a big difference there. So basically all this concrete would need to be knocked out, which I'll probably do that. That'll probably be the thing I do before the pad in the backyard. Knock out all this concrete and put in fresh, level like it's supposed to be.